In today's video, I'll show you how I sketched the floor plan of my room to scale. We are going to start this drawing by determining the scale, then sketch out the contour of the room, draw the contour of the walls, doors, and windows, fill out the walls with a color, and voila, one sketched floor plan. In order to complete today's exercise, you will need two things. You'll need to have the measurements of your room. If you don't have them, make sure to check out episode 4 in this playlist. And you'll need to have some basic understanding of floor plan metric scales. If you don't, make sure to check out episode 5 in this playlist. I will leave a link to each of these videos and the playlist in the description. If you want to take it very, very slowly and learn at your own pace, I know I did when I was learning this, you can download the final drawing I'm doing in this video and the drawings with the measurements that I'm using to create the floor plan as PDFs from the link in my description. Let's talk about tools. The tools I am using is my iPad together with an app called Procreate. It has a few useful tricks like being able to turn layers on and off or changing the intensity of the lines, but you can absolutely follow along with a pen and a piece of graph paper like this one here. I'm trying to impart to you architectural thinking, not artistic drawing, so Procreate is optional. Let's talk about paper size. For this exercise, you can use an A4 or an A3 piece of paper. I picked an A3 paper size because I want to work in a scale 1 to 20, and an A3 gives me more space for a bigger drawing. Let's talk about grid. To help you work in scale, you will need a grid. If you work with a normal graph paper, the grid lines are spaced 5 millimeters apart, which means that two of your squares make up 1 centimeter on your paper. Remember that, I'll come back to it when I talk about scale. I have created the same grids for my A3 paper in Procreate, so you are able to follow along. Scale. What scale should you work in? Personally, for interior design work, a good scale can be 1 to 20 or 1 to 25. For those who missed my last video, a scale of 1 to 20 means that 20 centimeters in real life are represented by 1 centimeter on my paper, or 2 of my little squares. So one of my squares represents 10 centimeters in real life. So in a scale of 1 to 20, 1 meter in real life will be represented by 5 centimeters on my paper, or 10 of these little squares. And on a scale of 1 to 25, 1 meter will be represented by 4 centimeters, or 8 little squares. I like to keep things simple and will work with a scale of 1 to 20. Alright, let's move to contour. We now want to draw the rough interior contour of the room. For this part of the drawing, you will want to pick a pencil that will help you make some very fine lines. These lines should be very light, because we will be drawing much stronger lines over them later on. I'll be using strong lines so you can see what I'm doing, but I will make them more transparent later on. You now want to take the width and the length of your room and convert it in little squares. So if I take a look at the measurements I made in episode 4, my room is 483.6 by 448.2 centimeters. This translates to 4.83 meters by 4.48 meters. Because one of my little squares represents 10 centimeters, this means my room is 48.3 squares by 44.8 squares. I want to start drawing a little dot for every 10 squares, or for every 1 meter, and I make a contour that is 48.3 squares by 44.8 squares. This is still not a very precise drawing due to the fact that we still continue to guess where to draw the line for anything less than 10 centimeters, but the guesstimation is about a couple of centimeters and not entire meters like we did in episode 3, and this will prove to be more useful in our design. As we continue to plan and the scale of the drawing increases, the guesstimation becomes smaller and smaller until it becomes a very precise drawing. But for the phase in the planning we are in, we do not need more than that. Now that we have the room's contour, we also want to draw the thickness of the walls. My wall at the top is 11 centimeters, so there is a 1 square thickness there. The one to the left is 70 centimeters, so there are 7 squares. My outdoor wall is about 55 centimeters, so there are about 5.5 squares. I don't know about the lower wall because it connects me with my neighbor, but I will assume that it has at least 20 centimeters, so there are at least 2 squares. So now that we have the overall contour, it's time to carve out niches and protrusions. The first protrusion is 24.7 centimeters, which is 2.5 squares, and 135.4 centimeters long, which makes it 13.5 squares. The second protrusion is 20.8 centimeters, so a bit over 2 squares. We have 85 centimeters, which is 8.5 squares away from the outdoor wall, and the protrusion itself is 48 centimeters, which is 4.8 squares wide. I hope by now you got the big idea of how to draw this in the scale of 1 to 20. It's time to mark the doors and windows. As a next step, I'm going to use this drawing where I wrote the dimensions and distances around my doors and window frames, and I will mark them on my drawing in scale. I also want to draw the thickness of these frames by adding a second line in front of the wall, as well as a line on each side to mark where the wall ends and the door frame begins. Time to make sense of this drawing. Wall contour. I hope so far you used the light pen like I recommended. I couldn't for teaching purposes, but what I will do now is take the layer on which these sketch lines are and make it lighter. Now I will make a new layer and draw the contour of the wall on it with a thick black pen. I don't go with the wall all the way to the edge of the door, but I try to leave a bit of space to mark the thickness of the wooden frame going all around the wall. Let's talk about frame's contour. In a pen that has a black but thin line, much thinner than the wall, I trace the frames of the doors and windows, as well as the windows themselves. I also keep this pen in a different layer. Doors. I forgot to sketch out the opening of the doors, so I'm doing this on a separate layer now. Both my doors open towards the interior of my room. This is actually useful to know when I plan my furniture. So I mark the middle of the door, and then I draw two semicircles that mark the door openings like this. This is the first sketch layer of the doors. I also want this sketch layer to be on a different layer than the rest of my sketches, so I can turn them on and off whenever I want. Just like before, over the open door sketch layer, I draw a more precise contour of the door on another layer. I also want to have the possibility to turn this layer on and off. Wall hatch. Finally, I pick a marker kind of pen and hatch out the walls just to make it stand out more. I turn off the grid and this is my final drawing. What do you guys think? It does look a little different proportionally from the drawing we originally guesstimated in episode 3, in that the room is almost a square, while we made it look more rectangular in episode 3. If you guys want to draw out your own room at your own pace, you can download my final drawing and the measurements drawings I have used in this video from the link in the description. Please subscribe to my channel, it helps me immensely to make content like this one, and if you want to see the rest of the videos from this playlist, make sure to check them out here.